I am Dr. Prakash Salunke, working as Associate Professor in Walchand Institute of Technology, Department of Mechanical Engineering. While discussing industrial management series, we shall be today dealing with the chapter Principles of Organizing 3. Last time we are already seen the organizing, principles of organizing, and certain principles that we have studied, division of labor, span of management, departmentation. Now, continuing our discussion further, today we shall discuss again departmentation. So, students will be, at the end of this session, student will be able to describe patterns of departmentation by product, by customer, etc., and we'll discuss merits and demerits of the same. Now, first, let us consider departmentation by product. Now, grouping of activities on the basis of products or product lines is done basically, rather than functions. For example, if a company has large scale and operating in different lines, one is cement line, one is automobile line, one is electrical line, say normally according to product and product line, say units are set up different. So this is known as departmentation by product. Now figure 1 shows the organization chart, organization structure based on this kind of departmentation. So here you can see, so this is a board of directors. So basically general managers are there, and under them again you will find manager product A. So for product A, there will be again separate units. Manager product B, product or product line, say like this, production finance. Manager C, again say third product, like that. So there can be different products and products lines. Say one may be, for example, say cement line, one may be say electrical line, automobile line, like that. Or some in automobile, there may be again say passenger vehicles here, then commercial vehicles here, heavy vehicles here, like that. You can have separate product division, So this is the chart showing the product departmentation. Now, the certain merits and demerits of each of them. In the merits, we can see that focus on the products or product lines. On a particular product and product line, there is focus of that entire department. So naturally, say that research and development, catering to needs of the customer, adding features in the product, removing the drawbacks in the product. So all that is focused. So that is the first advantage. Second advantage is that, say we are using specialized facilities for that product manufacturing. So it has all the advantage of specialized facilities, specialized machines, specialized skills, specialized knowledge that is required, etc. So naturally each specialization will lead to increase in efficiency, cost, rise in quality, like that. So all this will be, cost control. So all these are the naturally advantages. Then enable diversity of the product models and service. So that will arise in length and depth of product line. So naturally when we are concentrating on one product, say then naturally we shall be thinking of say developing different product models catering to different needs of the customer. So that will increase the depth of the product line, and adding the features and several models, so that will say increase the length, say adding different products in the same line. So that is the advantage of it. Say that way, within the same product line, so there'll be the diversities that will be achieved. So that will bring balance. So it will improve functional coordination because all are leading to, same product or product line. Then the responsibility of profit at that particular division. So for this product, what is the profitability that can be calculated separately by accounting, and so that becomes easy. Then it enables again development of general managers, because for each product or product line we require separate general manager and again functional manager, sub-functional manager, under him. Demerits, it requires again more general managers. So which are not easily available, effective managed, I mean. Economies of scale. So they are affected because for each department there will be separate purchasing, separate finance, separate human resources department. Naturally, so that happens. Especially for certain services like purchase, maintenance, etc. So that effect is more. Control more difficult for top management. Because each seven product manager will have his own demands and whole budgets and all these things. So, say naturally, say for achieving the coordination and balance and say of the resources and all these things, say top management skills say are naturally more skills are required. And generally more initial setup costs, again that is same just for just a territory. So similarly for each product division we have to say, I mean, set up all the machineries and plant and all these things, so that increase the cost. Then this one more way of say, I mean, departmentation is departments by customer or customer groups. So grouping activities serving to particular customer class or some large customers, so that is known as departments by customer. In case of certain industry where there are substantial or specific differences in the customer requirements, at the same time size of such segments, I mean customer segment is large enough so that we can cater them separately, say then this type of, I mean, departmentation is done. In industrial products, also this pattern is frequent. I mean, when we are supplying to industries, say then it is frequently used. Say figure 2, so that will show the organizational structure of a typical industrial unit. So which is using these departments by customers. So this is customer departmentation, say for say banking unit or finance, I mean finance sector. Say here the MD. Say one division particularly dealing with the ladies banking, giving specialized schemes to them and like the services. Then real estate and mortgage loans. So that are, that is one loan we know that home loans and like that. So that is very peculiar. For example, HDFC, Housing Development Finance Corporation. So that is one, so I mean, department for customer. Then corporate banking, serving to only corporates, agriculture area, school banking, like that. So these are the, according to customer class. So that is the departmentation done. So this is customer departmentation. Again, it has certain merits and demerits. The merits are like this. So enable focus on customer specific needs. So what are the needs of those who need the housing loans? So that there will be total focus on them, these customers. And say there will be again specialization, say for that. And say customer needs are addressed in better manner. Second is customer feeling proud and loyalty is ensured. So we are serving to that particular class of customer, or in certain cases we are leaving to only few customers, certain departments. So then say the customer feel that I am given some in priority, he feels proud, and say there are chances that he will remain more loyal, say, to your product or your brand. Then say it develops expertise in customer areas. Since we are working for the same kind of customer, so all the employees working in that particular department, say they will become expert, and the advantage of specialization will be achieved. Simultaneously, there are certain demerits. Difficult to coordinate operations because each department, say they will try to pull in their own ways. Then requires expert staff managers in particular field. Say for agriculture banking, for example, agriculture. So we need knowledgeable persons in that. Say like that for each customer. The customer groups may not always be clearly defined or demarked. So for all the products, so this is not possible. Say if we are selling, for example, cars general. So it's not able to differentiate, say according to customers like that. So for particular, certain products it is possible, for certain products it's not. then organization becomes rigid. Those who are serving, so because it is the disadvantage of too much specialization, again, the same thing happens. Cost may be more, so that naturally happens. And sometimes customer may be over demanding, because customer is given more prominence, so he wants his own ways, his more demands and more needs like that. So that may happen. So there are certain merits and demerits. Then there is a matrix organization. It is a grid or matrix type of departmentation. It combines functional and project or product type of patterns of departments in the same organization structure. So figure will illustrate this. This form is common in engineering and research and development departments and in certain product marketing organization, etc. Let us see the organization structure. So here, so this is the organization for publisher. Here we'll find that editorial, semin manager, production manager, design manager at the top level. And again, product wise, say book team A manager, book team B manager. So some may be publishing in engineering, some may be publishing in management area, some in say some history like that. So for each semin category, we'll have separate team and this editorial and this product team. So they will be combined together again, say this. So they'll be looking for their, books, say for editing, for production, that printing, binding, for the designing. So here, say for each of this, say you will find that everybody will be, catering. So that happens. So this is known as matrix organization. References, we have taken the references by book of Harold and Verich. I stop here. Thanks.